So this work center we will use in a different modules, like PP we will use and PM also we will use. And what is this work center means? This can be a mission or a person or a group of missions. So when you are doing a production or assembling a product, you will use some mission or you will do in a group of missions area.
Okay. You say mission, actually you talk about the machines, right?
Correct, machines only. Equipment, machines.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. So if that machines are using for production, mm-hmm. you can define them as a work center. You can define them as a work center. For example, car you are assembling using a one robot, automatic machine. Okay, you can make that as a work center. Work center means where you are performing the assembling, that center is called work center. This work center can be a machine or a person also, and group of missions also you can define as a work center. Okay, what is the purpose to define as a work center? One is you must calculate or you must know what is the capacity of a mission. Capacity. The reason is, for example, you can assemble 100 cars per day. That means that mission capacity is only 100 cars only it can assemble per day. If you want 200 cars, it cannot assemble that car, that mission. Okay, so to know your capacity of a plant or capacity of an assembly of a car, you should first know what is the mission capacity, how many cars it can assemble per day. You should know that. If you want to know in SAP, means you need a work center. So in the work center we will define what is its capacity. Okay, and next we will use this work center for scheduling. Wherever you see the scheduling means to calculate start and end dates. Scheduling means starting and ending dates calculation. For example, I said mission capacity is 100 per day. Okay, fine, 100. When is the mission starting and when is the mission stopping in a day? When means morning 8 o'clock it is starting and in the evening 6 o'clock that mission is getting stopped. Okay, that details you can put in scheduling. Okay, so wherever you see the scheduling.
Can I ask a question, sir? Just to ask you a question.
Yes.
But sometimes we can say each line of production, we can call it production center, work center, because sometimes maybe you find in the factory of car, maybe 3-4 lines, they start from scratch. We can say call each line work center, you know, we start from the beginning until, and I don't know if they do this kind of stuff in the car. They start 1, 2, 3, 4 cars at the same time to make the assembly. And can we say each line it is work center or what you think about it? Maybe does mean one factory can have 4 work center for the same car, one work center for the SIM card, or six work center for the SIM card. That's right. For the SIM design, I mean. Yeah.
Okay. I will answer to your question. First thing is, you are saying four cars can be manufactured at the same time in each line. That is nothing but a group of machine. Okay, group of machine means it is nothing but a line. You can say line one. Okay, one thing is how you can define this in SAP. Okay, so you can define them as individual lines, line one, like line two, line three, and line four. You can define them as individual lines. It is nothing but a work center one, work center two, individual work centers you can define. This is one way of defining. Okay, if for example all these are, you don't want to define them individually, four lines, you have four capacities, but you want to define as only work center, only one work center, you can define this as one work center. But in SAP you can maintain the capacity.
So in other words, if line one, line two, and line four,
yeah,
is the work center, and the line one has about four cars and line two has maybe 10 cars, so in other words, the capacity will be changed, but the work center will be the same.
Yes, correct.
I see. Okay.
Okay. So in line one, you can say 10 cars it can manufacture. This is 30 cars it can manufacture. This is 50 cars it can manufacture. Okay. Like this, if you have a multiple capacities, you can define them as a different lines and different work centers. If everything is same, like it, four lines, it can only produce 50 only, then in SAP you can define four capacities. You will create only one work center, but four capacities you can define.
So in SAP you have to create the capacity on plant level, I think, and then you have to assign this capacity to the work center.
Yeah, correct. Either you can do separately, you can create a capacity separately and assign to work center, or in the work center itself we can create. I will show you that.
I see. Okay,
inside of the work center itself we can create it.
Now one more question, I have, is the work center in production planning is the only one work center, or there are different types of work center in a production planning?
You can maintain a you can create a multiple work centers.
I see.
Okay, you can create multiple work centers. Like example, you have the four lines means you will create four work centers, and you will create a multiple work centers. For example, packing center is there. Packing center, you can create a one work center. Or painting, car manufacturing, painting is another work center you can create.
So these
you will create multiple work centers.
I see. So these work center, multiple work center, or triple work center, these work center are every work center is different from the other work center, correct?
Yeah, you can make it as a different.
Because one is, as you say, painter, one is assembly, one is something. So every work center will be a different work center.
Correct.
And every capacity has a different capacity.
Correct.
Okay, go ahead, please. I understand.
Okay. So, now, these work centers can be used for capacity and scheduling. And third one is costing. Okay, so for example, in this work center you are using this work center for 8 hours, fine. During that 8 hours you may be using a power to run that machine. After that you may be using some spare parts, and you will use some labor. So all these cost you need to measure.
I see.
Okay. So that measure you will do in costing. So you will maintain certain parameters also in the work center for the costing purpose. Otherwise, how costing people knows that what is the cost of this machine? So they will calculate, for example, for 8 hours, it's the cost running that machine is $100. Okay. So they will calculate per hour how much is its cost. Per hour may be $12. Okay. Or $11 per hour of its cost to run that machine. Okay. So that costing we will give the input in the work center, which is related to costing. Okay. So these are the three major purposes of this work center.
So if you calculate the costing in work center, it means the whole production planning, which starts from the point A to point Z, then you will calculate the cost of that product or cost of that car.
Yes.
Okay.
I will explain you during costing actually. Generally, costing means cost of a product. Means like example, our Honda car. What is the cost of this car means? One is your raw material cost. Okay, material cost. Second is your machine cost, machine running cost. That is nothing but a work center. You should measure this also, otherwise your actual cost will not come. Correct? Not only raw materials, you should know what is a machine running cost. Okay, inside of this machine running cost, you can calculate your power and all these costs, and labor costs also you can include this in work center. Okay, and there is a overheads cost will be there, so that is also included here. All these three cost together is your actual cost of a Honda car.
So what is the war cost?
Overhead cost is like, yeah, overhead cost is like which are you are not able to measure the cost. So those things they will put in a overhead. Example, like you are paying some interest to a bank. You borrow the money from the bank and now you are paying the interest to a bank. So that is a overhead cost.
Overhead, okay. So
you cannot measure that.
So you say earlier it was all three cost. But according to, as I understood, is 3, 4, 5 cost, material cost.
Yeah, correct.
And power cost, labor cost, and over is 4 material.
Yeah, so these, whatever I told you, the mission or everything, you will
cost.
Include in this. Yeah, you will include that in a machine running cost.
I see.
Your mission or labor, you will put these in a machine running cost, in work center costing.
I see.
I will show you that.
So these are 5 costs, means we have to consider material cost, raw material cost, and power cost, labor cost, overhead cost.
Yeah. Okay. So now I will show you this in SAP, you know, how to create this work center and everything. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now to create change and display, we will use the transaction codes CR01, CR02, CR03. These are the three transaction codes we will use.
When you are writing, I cannot see it. Are you using the same Excel sheet or different?
Yeah, I'm using the same Excel.
Well, it's not showing here. After line 4, you said WC4 line 4.
Okay.
And then after that, I did not see it.
Okay. Nicholas, are you able to see?
No, I don't see. Maybe it takes time to process.
Okay. Maybe it is taking time to appear.
Yeah, in Excel, after 131 serial number, after that it's not showing.
Okay, I put 133 is there, 136, 137, 138.
Yeah, we don't see it. Me. I don't know if it is, there is an issue with the server slow to display, because when you start, the screen below to compare it. And now the same, you know?
Oh, okay. Maybe because of
I think
some delay in the network.
Excel sheet is not moving upward.
Okay. 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 Now I open the SAP. Are you able to see SAP screen?
No.
Okay. I think.
Your side.
Okay. There is some delay in screen sharing.
Yeah. It's a good delay. It looks like 1 minute. I think 1 minute almost now, or more.
I will stop sharing it and I will share once again now.
Yeah.
Is it stop sharing now?
No.
No or yes?
No, we don't see any activities. Whatever you typing is nothing in there. I think
now any screen is showing to you?
Yeah, screen is there, but whatever you typing is not coming up.
Okay.
I would say you can use right hand. Okay. Now it's
gone.
Yeah, okay.
Beginning.
Now I'm once again sharing my screen.
Mm-hmm. Not yet.
Yeah, just now I began the screen sharing. Is it loaded now?
Not yet.
Okay.
I think take time because internet traffic is slow at this time.
Yeah, correct.
What happened actually, Mr. Vasu, this is a lot of people come from the job and everybody sitting at home and using the internet.
Yeah.
That's the main reason.
Still is not showing my screen?
No.
Oh, okay.
Srinivas, please rejoin the call.
Okay.
Let me just, you don't cancel the connection. Let me just do it.
Okay.
This conference will now be recorded.
But there's no point of waiting here, you know, for the as connection is not really good today. So we'll just end up the call today and then we'll reconnect and tomorrow same time. Okay.
Okay. On our side here in the entire US, the weather is pretty good and warm weather. It should be a good connection. There is no snow or bad weather here.
Yeah. We'll see. Like, you know, they should not be. We never had any problem from Srinivas end, but only today, you know. So we'll check it out in the offline. We'll rectify it. Okay.
Okay. So tomorrow.